right. Welcome, everyone. Welcome back from lunch. I hope you're all enjoying today. I know I am, being here, seeing a lot of people, listening to interesting lectures from a lot of other companies and vendors. Today I'm going to talk about analytics framework, but I will actually start off with a call to action. I believe strongly in using data for good, and I'm very happy and proud to work for a company that takes climate change, sustainability and health really seriously, and have that as an integral part of our business. And as a receipt on that, ICA has actually received a UN award that will be presented in November, and it's the second one we've received from United Nations for our work with reducing our climate footprint. And back then to the call for action, and that is, I want you all to think about how can I use data when I do my good sustainability and climate actions. And if you use data before, during, and after, there are a few things you can achieve. First of all, we can focus on doing the right things, doing the things that will give the most effect, as well as we can also measure the effect it actually has when we have done the change. What did it look like before? What did it look like after? At ICA, we are following the science-based target initiatives. They are doing a development of a new standard for measuring net zero. It's not completely done. Once it's done, we will try to follow that as strictly as possible. Into, first of all, who I am. I'm Olof Granberg. I work at ICA Gruppen. I work with data and advanced analytics tech. And I started working within the analytics space back in 2006. And I am still at it. This is the area where I really enjoy being and really enjoy working in. I will start by painting a bit of a scenario to get into the topic of the day. So paint a scenario. You've argumented for a while on C-level with your company management, with your board, to do a restart of your analytics organization, of your journey, becoming truly data-driven. And you've gotten that support. You get a budget, you get priority, and so on. And that is great. But you don't really know where to start. So you start where you actually want to make an impact. You start with the use cases. And this is the way. This is the way to start. But after quite a short time, you start running into foundational issues, such as what data platform should I use? How do I get data into that platform in a good manner? How do I access the data? How do I let my data scientists work with that data, what tooling should they have, and so on. So you start sorting out all of the technical details, you start on the most prioritized platforms, and so on, and continue implementing your use cases. And starting to progress, you launch more and more teams because you want to scale it out, and going with a more decentralized approach. You start creating teams that manage their own products and build their own use cases. But those teams start running into problems of their own, how they run into data governance issues, for instance, like what data can I use for my domain? Where is that data located? How is it defined? How is it profiled? Who owns it? What am I allowed to do with it, and so on. So you start sorting those processes out and start working on it. And after a while, you've kind of sorted that out and are starting to roll again with more teams and more implementations. And when then you start wanting to change the business in a more disruptive way and you see that a lot when you want to make a change that goes cross-team, you see that the every team has built it everything their own way. So making a change becomes a very, very big issue. And out of that short scenario, we can identify two main pain points. The first of which is knowing the complete map. What needs to be done? What is our whole scope? If we don't just focus on technology, we don't just focus on one area. What's the whole scope? With everything from data domains to platforms to data science to working with the end result and so on. The second part is how when you start scaling teams, you have a team and then you add another and then and another, and after a while you add more and more teams because you want to progress faster and faster. And the problem now is that a lot of these teams are doing the same thing, but in their own way. They're building a lot of foundational components, which they need to complete their use cases. However, everyone is doing more or less the same thing over and over again. And is the problem then that we have many teams? No, it's not that is the problem. The problem is that they are doing the same thing, but in separate ways. So to address these two pain points, I recommend working with frameworks and adopting that way of working that you need to adopt around frameworks. And I will talk a little bit about two dimensions to the frameworks. The first is the complete map. How does a full analytic framework look like? What are example dimensions, sub-dimensions, and so on to put into such a framework? The second is going into how can teams collaborate around the framework without losing agility and without making it be very, very centralized. So before we jump into that, I want to just talk a little bit about what is a framework. And I've used Cambridge Dictionary's two definitions that we can start to take a starting point on. And they, first of all, define a framework as something that is a supporting structure around which something can be built. Kind of abstract, but two concrete examples around it is the first of which is code frameworks. Most of us are using it every day in one implementation or another. Things like Spark or SIO. That is used by engineers and scientists around the companies to integrate data, to transform data, to analyze and execute data pipelines. The second framework we can use as an example of this is the DevOps or MLOps frameworks that also a lot of us are using every day. And within that framework or scaffolding, if you will, we are building our functionality. We're building our data pipelines. We're building our models and so on. But we're using that whole framework to simplify a lot of the recurring tasks that we would otherwise have to do each and every time we build something. The second definition that Cambridge Dictionary uses is that a framework is a system of rules, ideas, or beliefs that is used to plan or decide something. Now we get into a more theoretical area. And a good example here is a data governance framework, which describes how do we work with data as our strategic asset. Who is responsible for the data? Who is responsible for what we're allowed to use with the data? How does that process look like? How do we involve privacy office and so on? But it also goes into how do we measure data quality? How do we work with data quality in a structured manner? And how do we document what data we have, what we're using it for, how is it defined, and so on? And it sounds a bit like everything would be easier if we just centralized everything and did everything in one box. And had a process that everyone followed. We had a solution that everyone uses. But we all know that after a certain scale, that does not really work, that doesn't scale out. So we then look at what are traits around good frameworks that actually scale. First of all, a framework should be voluntary. They should never be mandatory to use because because the framework is there to help. A lot of the tasks will be mandatory. Right to be forgotten from GDPR, that is something we need to do. But a framework can help with that, but it doesn't necessarily state that you need to use the framework to do it. And as I said, a framework is designed to help. It's there to abstract away a lot of the recurring tasks that could be done in separate ways, could be done even manually in some cases, but preferably we want to abstract away everything that's done twice, we should put as a reusable component. And last but not least, a framework should never ever be static. It should be continuously evolving. It is something that, if we take that stance that a framework is there to help and it's never static, we can start small. We can continuously evolve that framework, add to it, incrementally update the existing components and make them better all the time. That also means that we can fail in some components. We can create some components that we really, really believe in, and then it turns out that none of our data engineers uses it because it's not what they actually needed. And that is fine. Then we decommission that, build something else. Jumping then into what I personally choose to call the analytic framework, and that is the complete map, basically describing what are the different dimensions we need to take care of, be they theoretical, such as data governance responsibility, or be they code framework around how we do data ingestion. There are a number of levels to the analytical framework. First of all, we need to work with our strategies and then describe what are the strategies we need? What do the strategies tell us? What do we need to put in the strategies? And then we come into analytical products. How do we work with products? How do we know whether or not to evolve an existing product, add a new product, decommission one? How do we work with them? Analytical processes. How do we work with building use cases of one case where we know what we want in the end, another where we need to start experimenting because we're not really sure? And how do we work with self-service analysis out in the business? Governance is something that is not limited to data governance. There are a number of different topics we need to address. Some of those were actually addressed before around data mesh. How do we govern our data mesh product? Then we have the whole section around data. How do we work with data? How do we get it in? How do we manage it? Work with the data throughout its life cycle. Same thing with our machine learning models. We need to work with them throughout their model, throughout their lifetime. Foundation is a bit of a generic term, but that is where a lot of the foundational components goes in, where if several teams are working on the same reusable components, that goes in there. We have platforms such as data platforms, machine learning platforms, visualization platforms, and so on. Last but not least, we need to sort out how do we support our teams, how do we support our business, how do we deliver things. And looking into each of these, there are a number of subsections. Looking at the strategy, for instance, we have business strategy that feeds into an analytic strategy, and both of them are supported by a data strategy. Within governance, there are also a number of areas to address. In data ops, there are many areas to address, depending on how you slice and dice the level. The same goes with on a platform level. There are many things to address. Diving then to the next level into one example, could be data ingestion in this case, where we have a number of things to do. We grab data from wherever it lives. We need to store it. In some cases, we need to archive it. How do we work with error handling, making data available, and how do we clean up? And all of this can be, and we need to orchestrate it, we need to monitor it. And all of this can be put into one or several code frameworks that allows our team to work together on the same thing. And continuing with that example, we have the first team that starts working with creating a data ingestion framework. They're starting to add more and more functionality. They start using it themselves and keep expanding on it. Once it comes to a certain level, when they feel it's mature enough, they make it available for other teams that want to start using it. And that is all well and good until the day that the second team finds that, well, hang on, here we're missing a part here. We're missing an XML parser. As example, because no one has needed that before. So they add that to the same framework. And then, so in that manner, those teams can continue bringing the whole framework further along so that the next team and the next team and the next team can get a faster start. They can add things that they need. We're not constrained by having a centralized team that creates all of the components before the business value creation teams use them. There are some things you need to put in place in order to work successfully with the frameworks. You need to think about, how do I sort out governance? Can anyone commit to the centralized framework, or do I need to create a small council of senior data engineers, for instance, that approve? So say that you have a number of those, when out of 10 senior data engineers, 3 must approve a commit. There are different models of how to work with it. The open source community has worked with it extensively. Easiest, I think, is to copy that way of working. Also depends on the size of your company. But if you work with frameworks and take that approach, all of the teams can benefit from the foundation work done by the other teams. So, finally, what would I like for you to pack in your lorries and bring with you when you go home? The first part is finding the right level to start. And that is extremely dependent on what kind of company you are, what is your purpose as a company. And finding the right level to start could be financial reporting, if that's what you really need. But it can also be a machine learning model that governs a part of a production plant. Collaborate between teams. I think I cannot stress this one enough. If you don't do anything else, please collaborate between the teams and start building a reusable component between you. The third, and that goes together with everything else, work with voluntary frameworks, because a framework will get traction if it's good. Don't force it on people, because then they're less likely to use it. So please work with voluntary frameworks and think about, they are there to help. And last but not least, don't do it as a one-time effort. Now we created a framework. Yay, let's use it. And then 2 years later, you're finding out that this isn't what we need anymore. Actively evolve your frameworks. Work with them. Thank you.